An unprecedented decision which was taken here in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. And obviously, certain steps and measures and restrictions were imposed, which too were unprecedented. But how exactly is the administration coping with the challenge? Because we all know the real challenge will begin now as schools reopen, as landlines are restored, and the clampdown is removed. You can't perpetually keep a state in a state of lockdown. So what is the long-term strategy? And to discuss this, I have the man who will have the best answer to this particular question, Mr. K. Vijay Kumar, the advisor to the Jammu and Kashmir governor. Thank you very much, sir, for speaking to NDTV.
I'll try my best to give you some acceptable answers.
Okay. When
you use words like clampdown, lockdown, or containment, putting the lid, these are all extremely negative terms by the very nature, and I do admit that it has got a negative connotation. Mm-hmm. But what is important is the objective or the purpose behind. Mm-hmm. We have strictly kept in mind what was in the rearview mirror, meaning what has happened in 2010, for example. Yeah. I'm sure you will know from your archives, and public have not forgotten, that there were more than 110 deaths during the 2010 agitation.
Correct.
And what happened there? Nearly 73 days, there was a shutdown, mm-hmm. hartal and close down, etc., 73 yes. days. And our average during the last 10 years has been 50 days of hartal. Mm. And when you talk about averages and it becomes statistics and it becomes as if you are disrespectful of the numbers, but nevertheless, statistics is important. Mm. And when you talk about 50 days of average in the last 10 years, I also want to say there were average of 12 firings every year and nearly 50 people got killed in every year. Mm. This is no justification to say that we should maintain that level. I'm not saying that at all, because these are all morbid figures, but to your security man, morbid details are essential. Mm. I can put the things in perspective. Mm. Before that, what happened in 2008, you have more than 172 days of closed down Amarnath Yatra, and nearly 82 people were killed in more than 40 incidents of firing. Now, let's get back to 2016. You are all familiar with Burhan Wani.
Absolutely.
It's very much in our memory.
Absolutely.
What happened was that in the first few days, there were 41 deaths, and 82 people got killed, and nearly in 40 incidents. Mm-hmm. There again, there was a long lockdown. So things have happened, unfortunately, for the people of this place, having to brace out, having to face this kind of difficult situation, because it has got antecedents, because it has got some previous history, and the history has not been too good during these times. We are being very wary of saving the human life. It could be your life, it could be mine as well, or it could be any common citizen. So in the balance of security and liberty, what happens is the common man gets a little bit inconvenienced. But it's a very conscious decision. We are aware that there will be a lot of discomfort, but it is a decision taken at various levels, and we are watching it every day. So
okay.
when to the word. The word you used was clampdown and lockdown. Mm. We'll be slowly unwinding. We have started the process.
Mr. Vijay Kumar, what I'm going to do is, or main beech beech mein Hindi bhi isliye bolunga, kyunki the most of the questions that I've prepared around security, they are after speaking to the local people. Un logon ke sawal hain, aur zahir si baat hai, janta ke sawal hain, to wo jo pratinidhitva kar rahe hain shasan ka, unse ye sawalon ke jawab chahenge. To sabse pehla sawal ye tha ki, was this amount of clampdown required, is tarike ke steps ki zarurat kyun thi?
Maine abhi abhi bataya aapse, maine aapse kaha ye pichle kahi varshon ke andar kitna damage hua tha public ka. Maine kaha ye 2010 mein kareeb 110 se zyada people had to die. So every time there was a upheaval or a problem here, law and order situation, things had gone pretty bad. We are very clear this time we should try to save as much of life as possible.
Okay.
And in fact, the bottom line was no loss of life, and we are working towards that. When you are working towards an extreme kind of solution or option, in the interest of common people, we inevitably take some measures, and that is what has happened. Therefore, when you say lockdown, I won't say that, okay, these people are used to it. Ye log toh pehle bhi pariche hai, ye log familiar hai. I am not saying that. I am saying that we are conscious of the difficulties, but ye karna padta tha. Humne both soch samajh ke ye karwai humne ki.
One of the concerns that people had, I mean, abrogation of 370 is besides the point. I'm not going to get into that because, you know, that's...
Nor will I.
My, you know, one concern that I could see on the ground related to security was that the security forces, in order to maintain calm and quiet, did not allow the people to celebrate Eid. They could not freely move around. How would you respond to this?
I would say, earlier in 2016, there was greater restriction during Eid. This time, Honorable Home Minister and our Governor and NSA were clear, we should give them as much facilitation as possible. Yes, sahi nahi hai ki pura hume band ho gaya. Wherever the bigger congregations are likely, we were a little restrictive about that. Again, because of public safety and security concern. Imagine, for an instance, during such a celebration, somebody, a bad guy comes and takes advantage. What will happen? Is it not it will not be a very pretty sight to have on such a holy occasion, important occasion, some serious debilitating kind of occurrences. Therefore, we took a decision and it was done. It was not in any muted manner, I would say. Yes. It was the usual fervor and big crowd was not there, but we had to do this because of the reasons correct, I told you.
Correct. Mr. Vijay Kumar, I'm sure you realize that the real challenges lie ahead for the administration. Yes. So I'm going to divide this in four categories, and I would request if you could speak about these four categories. First of all, the mobsters or the stone pelters. What is your strategy going to be now that there is relaxation? It is expected that there will be some disturbance in some pockets.
Now the mobsters are indeed one of the what you call ranks in the whole ladder of mischief makers. But above him stands the overground worker, or you can call him the underground worker also, because he's either way. He sometimes is overground, underground. We call him the mover and shaker. He's a very dangerous guy. And he looks sometimes very respectable. I'm talking about guys like Masarat Alam, you may remember. So the guy was financing and funding and looking after, but he was never caught till the end. Now he is facing his nemesis now. Such kind of fellows were the guys we want to clean out. And then above him, you got the militant who will take advantage of the situation like he did in 90s. When stone throwing is going on, he will try to do some mischief from there. And then you got the bad religious leaders, the imams and mullahs, very few, very happily, situation is very, very minuscule minority are there. Nevertheless, these guys have to be kept under watch. So when you talk about all these mobsters, we don't sort of isolate them. We see the whole spectrum and see how they fit in. And by taking what kind of actions, you'll be able to have overall control.
So that's, Mr. Vijay Kumar, according to you, that's a concerted approach of the bad Maulana, the mobsters, movers and shakers, and militants.
Absolutely correct.
Should I assume that this is...
not my invention. This is a term based on a consensual discussion with our SHO upwards. We discovered that which are the things, and easy to remember, easy to remember kind of formula, and we are all focused on this.
Am I to assume that this is going to be the strategy to deal with these four M's?
No, in policing, we don't call it a strategy, we call it an operational tactics or a tactical approach to the situation.
Okay. Another thing, as far as these stone pelters are concerned, it is a fact, and I know most of their leaders who used to incite, some of them are in detention, some behind bars, some preventive detention. Now these people are leaderless. Do you think that this is a good or bad sign? Because, you know, being leaderless could also mean that now they're unpredictable.
Yeah, it's both. But the mob rarely abhors a vacuum of leadership. There will be some other leader who will try to emerge. But I concede the point that it is better to have a mob with a leader and a mob without a leader, because anarchy is going to be very heavy in a leaderless crowd. It may morph into absolutely total uncontrollable. But what we are noticing is, as soon as we clear the top crust, there is other ones emerging slowly, and so we are clearing the next crust. So how long and how far it will go is a matter of our consideration.
How do you penetrate as far as their leadership is concerned? Because, you know, your biggest I would assume that the biggest challenge is going to be to know what lies ahead or what they will do.
We've got a gully-gully intelligence kind of system. We've got eyes among the public. A lot of public are with us. And only thing is they're a little hesitant to come openly. So there are subtle messages. And JK Police is one of the strongest in terms of the operational and intelligence. So they pick up what is happening on the ground. We have got our ears close to the ground. And we try to find out what's happening in the Mohalla.
Sir, two, three janta ke sawal phir related to security. One is that schools are going to reopen on Monday. And parents are concerned that do you really expect that at a time like this, they will send, and that to primary school children, to school? What about their safety and security? And the other big concern, agar kuch communicate karna hai school se, to karein kaise? Wo phone to chali nahi raha, mobile. There is no message which will be exchanged.
Okay, mobile will be the other end. Now we have started with the landlines, and we'll slowly take it as we progress towards mobile. I'm confident. At the moment, the coverage of landlines is considerable now. It is now almost reached from 50% to 2/3 now. Soon we'll be touching the 100% in the valley. Soon. Now, as regards your question, we are also equally concerned, like the parents. We are also equally concerned about the safety, if not more in a sense. And it is not as if that we wanted to open the school. The demand came from the ground, spontaneously from the parents. It is all localized demands. It is not a general order from the education department, nor was it the chief secretary or the governor. But when the demands came from the parents, because children are cooped up in home, they wanted, then we said, okay, we'll open up slowly. It's a considered decision.
But can you ensure safety?
Yeah, we are doing everything to ensure the safety.
Okay. Now, sir, you were saying?
Now, there are other things involved in the safety. You should have mobility. You should have small vehicles. Or you should have school buses. I mean, it's a chain of this thing. It's not linear. Many things have to happen at a time. Mm-hmm. We are conscious of that also. Like you said about phones.
Yeah.
You said about the schools. You said I mentioned about the transport and so on.
Sir, another concern that came from the people is that who uses landline in this day and age? In any case, they are on a steady decline. I mean, this is a relic from the past, from the 80s. A mobile phone ka zamana hai, isme everybody is on the mobile phone. So by restoring landlines, in fact, I want to share a very interesting, I went to the Lal Chowk BSNL exchange. I saw a steady stream of people going and re-registering for the landline phones.
No, I don't want to sound very flippant or irreverential. I read in media that many people have taken to writing letters and so on.
Yeah.
And when you say that we have opened the landlines, which is antediluvian or very archaic, I think it still has got a role in the absence of other things. Then only the value of this thing will go up. Our aim is not to put up the importance of, again, show to the public, that, yeah, come back to landline. That's not our aim at all.
Mm.
It becomes a collateral aspect of the whole span of actions.
Mm-hmm.
And we willy-nilly had to come to landline because in the absence of other things, landline will serve a purpose. Imagine in a mohalla, two people have a landline, and there people are very friendly and very, very what you call, garrulous and together here, and they'll be able to help out each other. Already, I believe the landline use has spiked. This is not to say that we are not going to do anything about the cell phones.
Mobile phones.
Because mobile phone has become a personal gadget.
Yeah.
It has become like extension of your palm. Therefore, we realize how important sensitive it is, and we are doing everything to make it possible to open these lines as quickly as possible.
I want to give you a feedback also after speaking to some youth from the downtown area. They said that because of the internet, they were hooked on to video games like PUBG. And now there is no internet. You expect that this angry people will now hit the roads. I mean, mobile was a sort of an addiction, which in a way was helping reduce, protest and agitation on the road.
Yeah.
That's one of the perils, the other side of the story.
You know, it is both ways.
Yeah.
So when the same mobile can be used for certain other purposes which are not conducive to the overall situation here, that is a consideration for us to enter. Otherwise, it's not to deprive anybody of a pleasure, anybody of a normal communication model channel, and to take him back by edges, to take him back to Stone Age. That was not the intention at all. When you're talking about downtown, there are a lot of engagements which we were also involved in from the sports department. There are a lot of floodlit court which have been opened there in that area. Gandhi Memorial, for instance. People didn't imagine Gandhi Memorial ground will have a floodlit. I myself went there. And in a place like that, we are doing many things to penetrate and reach out to the youth. And of course, because of this, that had to slow down, and I'm sure we'll resume.
Okay.
This anger or this, unrest or being restive, it's a temporary phase. I'm sure we'll get over the hump and tackle.
Mere do akhri sawal after that. I know you're a busy man, I'll let you go. Rumor mongering, right? Now, again, feedback from the people. They say that when you clamp down on communication systems, it will lead to more rumor mongering as opposed to the systems restored. Because say for instance, if there's someone who's outside, usko malum nahi hai uske ghar mein kya ho raha, usne kuch baat suni, lekin ab wo confirm nahi kar sakta ki sach kya hai because of the communications blockade. They feel that this blockade is leading to more rumors.
Okay, I would say put it this way, the rumor monger, number of rumors may be more in the absence of communication, but the quality of rumors will be less. Quality means my ability to, by word of mouth spreading, I'll be able to reach out to 100 mouths. Whereas if I'm digitally open, I will reach out to million ears. So which is more important, you yourself would know. But I concede the point that in the absence of any correct information, and that's why we are trying to reach out through our own thing. Though you may say the penetration is minimal or not ideal, we are trying to reach out and tell the public, these are the facts. Hajj pilgrims, for example, there were a lot of confusion about what. Immediately there was an outreach to them through the MEA. All the departments fell in line. The people who are working far away, facilitation centers, to the extent we can mitigate the difficulties we have been trying to do, and we need to do much more, we are at it very much. But the point again, I would repeat, the advantage of a digital medium for rumor mongering is more when it is
for
available.
For negative news.
Yes, for the negative news. Therefore, we have to see.
For instance, you wanted to put a lid on fake news?
Absolutely. Fake news is more dangerous than any news, because fake news, once it comes and reaches a certain pitch, it picks up a velocity.
Would there be an example that you'd like to share?
There are plenty of examples. I already pointed out to another friend of the media that they put up a pictures of women protesting, and then we found out the women were wearing a winter dress, and this is not the winter time. Winter is 3 months away. It is not Chilakalan at all. We are just going to enter the autumn. So that was a very funny, ill-thought and very hasty kind of thing, some photoshopping. Like that, we found many of the pictures and videos were all coming from different era and different agitation, nothing to do with this one. So very unintelligent, but that we will be able to say only later. Supposing it picks up and already 1 million people have viewed it, and now what is the impact? It's like a mental grenade. It has entered the minds of so many people. Then to remove the, remove the pollutants, it becomes extremely difficult. That is the danger of digital fast news.
Okay. My final question to you, Mr. K. Vijay Kumar. There is a feeling, and ye sawal aapse puchna isliye zaruri hai kyunki ye ek feeling hai logon ke man mein ki ab jab se ye faisla hua hai, isko lekar ke jo forces hain, यानी कि जो यहाँ की स्थानीय फोर्स है जम्मू कश्मीर पुलिस, उनमें जाहिर सी बात है वो इसी समाज में से आते हैं, तो अगर इस समाज के एक तबके में अगर थोड़ा रिजेंटमेंट है तो उस फोर्स में भी रिजेंटमेंट होगा. मैं आपसे जानना चाहता हूँ, एज अ पर्सन हुज पार्ट ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, हाउ डू यू रिस्पॉन्ड टू अ क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस?
आई हैव डेल्ट विद दिस फोर्स earlier also 2 decades ago, and I've been constantly watching the progress of this force for a long time. I've been a vicarious reader of this team, because I have handled left-wing extremism in 7-8 states. I have seen the synergy of all those states, and I have seen what is here. I would say this is ranking number one. I am not saying here because I happen to be here. Absolutely dispassionately, that is my considered view. In terms of the sacrifice, they themselves have more than 1,250 or odd numbers. They have got killed, constabulary to senior officers. And senior officers, guested officers, more than 25 have got killed. That means the high quality of leadership. They're absolutely professionals. And this kind of, dissenting kind of thing, and kind of somebody planting a news saying that they're all absolutely nothing. I find them...
But there was some news, no?
This is one of those news. Yeah. The kind of...
Fake news.
Fake news.
What was that fake news?
Saying that there is a dissent between them and the CRP, and there was a kind of fragging or something and all. This is very dangerous. This kind of planning. This is where I seek your cooperation. I have solicited the cooperation of all languages in India, so that we fight this. Because once it starts spreading, what a dangerous thinking it is, that the forces will fight among themselves, there will be anarchy, anomic condition.
Mutiny.
And insurgency in this side. This is not a... I think therefore we have to curb this tendency, we have to kill this attitude, and we need to take action on them. We are looking at the legal angles for this also.
Oh, legal angle for this?
Definitely.
Just in case somebody spreads this rumor.
Unless he verifies.
Of resentment among the forces.
There are IT Act, there are certain sections in the IT Act, as you may be aware, which says that if you are innocently watching something, you are not culpable. But if you are propagating it, you are spreading it. Pornography is one instance like that. This is worse than pornography. This is more dangerous. Pornography, you pollute certain group. Here you are damning a whole nation, and you are trying to create a situation which is only helpful to you. And on whose terms and for whose side you are working. So therefore, Indian nations and the entire neutral media everywhere should get together and kill these kind of bad efforts.
Mr. K. Vijay Kumar, thank you. It was a pleasure talking to you, sir.
Likewise.
Thank you.